Hey everyone, welcome to the fifth episode of the story of my Kutch. Right now we are heading towards Harami Nala, and I have been told that the videography will not be allowed once we reach the BSF post. So sorry, but won't be able to show you the visuals. However, I will share my experience with you later. Everyone that visits Kutch falls in love, and flamingos are no exception. The lesser invited their cousin, the greater flamingo. The greater flamingos initially came as migratory visitors, fell in love with the salinity of Kutch Desert, and are now declared permanent residents. Literally standing tall on the title of state bird, the greater flamingos are a beautiful sight to behold all around Kutch. So we are back from the Harami Nala, and it was such an amazing experience. Just once in a lifetime experience, and I'll remember this for the whole of my life. So jo BSF officer the who accompanied us to the Harami Nala, I asked him a few questions. तो पूछा कि क्या आप पाकिस्तानी पकड़ते हैं वहाँ पे. सो हरामी नाले पे क्या है, 20 फीट का दलदल है. हरामी नाले पे बहुत सारा जेंगा मछली होता है. सो पाकिस्तान से ज़्यादा इंडिया की साइड पे वो जेंगा मछली ज़्यादा मिलता है. तो पाकिस्तानी जो बोट्स होते हैं वो आ जाते हैं धीरे धीरे करके. उनको पता नहीं चलता कि वो इंडिया है या पाकिस्तान है, क्योंकि सी बॉर्डर है. तो वहाँ पे कोई पिलर नहीं लगा, कुछ नहीं लगा. तो गलती से वो पाकिस्तानी बोट्स आ जाते हैं यहाँ पे मछली पकड़ते पकड़ते, उसके मछुआरे आ जाते हैं. तो जैसे ही वो क्रॉस करते हैं तो इंडिया वालों को तो इंडिया वाले पकड़ लेते हैं. और ऑलमोस्ट लाइक अराउंड 50 से भी ज़्यादा लोग पकड़ते हैं वो लोग साल में. तो ये BSF वाले पुलिस को हैंड ओवर कर देते हैं जो भी मछुआरे पकड़ते हैं. तो फिर उनको साल 9 महीने रखते हैं और फिर वापस छोड़ देते हैं. तो इसी जेंगा मछली के चक्कर में वो पाकिस्तानी पकड़े जाते हैं. और उसके बाद इधर हरामी नाले पे 4 यूनिट्स हैं BSF के. तो उसमें से एक यूनिट जो है वो बोट पे ही रहता है वहाँ पे हरामी नाले पे. तो या दैट इज़ देयर लाइफ. सो या ये सब बात हुई उनके साथ, एंड दे वर सच अमेजिंग पीपल ओवर देयर. ऑल द BSF सोल्जर्स एंड द ऑफिसर्स एंड एवरीवन, दे वर जस्ट अमेजिंग. एंड इट वॉज एन अमेजिंग एक्सपीरियंस, एंड आई होप यू ऑल्सो गेट दिस एक्सपीरियंस वंस. सो दिस रिमाइंड्स मी ऑफ द टाइम व्हेन आई हैड विजिटेड सिरक्रिक, विच इज़ द सी बॉर्डर बिटवीन इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान. आई थिंक आई वॉज अराउंड 10 ईयर्स ओल्ड देन, बट आई स्टिल रिमेंबर द होल एक्सपीरियंस. एंड दिस वॉज जस्ट लाइक दैट. So now we have just stopped at a random place to have our lunch. We have brought some snacks with us, and you can have food at Kateshwar Mahadev if you want, and if you have not brought anything from home, but we have just brought some thepla and stuff. So we'll finish eating and then go to Zara. We are done with lunch and now we are going to Zara. It is around 12 kilometers from Gadhuli, and today Gadhuli is the focal point. Everything is around Gadhuli only, that is Siyod, Kateshwar Mahadev and Zara. And Gadhuli is 3 kilometers from Dayapur, that is the headquarters of Lakhpat Taluka. Is the head that wears the crown. The history of Kutch documents 9 battles, and this land here is witness to 6 of them. We are at the battlefield of Zara. Today we will talk about the 2 main wars that were fought over here. They have also built this Zara Veer Shahid Smarak over here to commemorate the soldiers who lost their lives for Kutch. Zara has not had a highlighted mention in our history books like the Kurukshetra War or the War of Panipat, but however that does not make it any less important. The first war was fought in 1520 when Sultan Shah Hussein of the Argun dynasty, after dethroning Jamfiroz of Thatta in Sindh, followed him, Meanwhile, Jamfiroz had sought refuge with Rao Khengarji, who was the ruler of Kutch at that time. Well, Rao Khengar had previously helped Mir Jafar, who was the kin of Jamfiroz, in establishing his claim over a quarrel-ridden Sindh. And hence, Jamfiroz took it for granted that Rao Khengar would also help him as he had helped his kin Mir Jafar. The armies of Rao Khengar were defeated badly, the lives were lost and the royal treasury became a lot lighter. But Rao Khengar became lucky because the Mughal king Humayun attacked Sultan Shah Hussein immediately after the first war of Zara. So Kutch remained with Khengarji. Khengarji had burnt his finger, learnt his lesson and never interfered again in the matters of Sindh. He went on to rule Kutch for 76 years. The first 76 years of the 438 years of the rule of the Jadeja dynasty in Kutch. The second time the waters of the river flowed red with blood was more than 200 years later in 1761 when Goraji ascended the throne.
To be fickle-minded and immature at the age of 26 was definitely not a kingly characteristics, and that was the reason that Goraji went down in the history of Kutch as the worst ruler of the Jadeja dynasty. The engineers of every war are either bad decision makers or ambitious, egoistic people.
The second war of Zara had both these reasons as its roots, the bad judgment of Goraji and over-ambition of one Punjaset. Goraji was the only legitimate heir of Lakhaji. However, he lived in exile with his mother and Punjaji, who was his mentor. When Goraji ascended the throne, instead of appointing Punjaset as his second in command, he appointed Jivanji, who was a great diplomat, but he lacked the intelligence and experience of Punjaset. And as they say, enemy's enemy is a friend. And now Punjaset looked at Goraji and Jivanji as his enemy, and their enemy was Ghulam Shah Kalora of Sindh. So he shook hands of friendship with Kalora, and together they set out for Kutch with a very well-trained army. The Kutchis fought heroically out of patriotism, even the women fought side by side. But Kutchis had not fought any war in the last 200 years. Even the 12 Bhayats that made up the Kutchi front did not know how to unite the individual bands. Sindhis, on the other hand, after perpetual warfare and constant invasion, had mastered the art of war, and the Kutchis were slaughtered and killed. The 12 Bhayats that made the Kutchi front were killed that fatal morning as Kalhora rode his victory horse towards Bhuj, where Gorji was stationed. As Kalhora rode towards Bhuj, the Queen Mother realized that if Kalhora reached Bhuj, his son was not capable of withstanding another attack. So, if it was not for that one grey hair, I would not be standing here on this battlefield. The widowed Queen Mother sent a single strand of grey hair in a small little box to Punjaset, imploring him not to disgrace her in her old age, promising him the rightful position of Diwan as soon as he brought a reconciliation with Kalhora. Punjaset could not ignore this request, and he had already seen the brutality that was going on and all the people that he loved were being killed. So it is Punjaset's political strategy that saved Kutch from immediate predicament.
A bargain was struck and Kalhora agreed to retrace his steps. Thus, Kutch did not become a part of what we now call Pakistan. Right now, we are at the top of the Zara Hill where we can see the whole battlefield. When Modi ji was the chief minister of Gujarat, he used to celebrate Asadi Beach, the Kutchi New Year, here on Zara Hills. Since then, a Shraddhanjali Sabha is organized every year on these grounds. It is proposed to make a memorial on 40 acres of land that the government has granted. Audiovisual recreation of the War of Zara will make the future generations aware of the spirit of patriotism of our ancestors. The museum will be similar to the Haldighati War Museum in Rajasthan. That was the battlefield of Zara for you. Next, we are going to Matanamadh, which is 35 kilometers from here. Jai Ma Ashapura, the war cry of the Jadeja dynasties. The powers may have been taken away from the kings. The kingdoms may have collapsed. But the faith that Ma Ashapura will always bring victory is stronger than ever before. Even the Prime Minister, Sri Narendra Modi, sounded the bugles of his war-footed election campaign from Matanamadh
after bowing his head to the principal deity of Kutch, Ma Ashapura, for her blessings. There will hardly be a Kutchi that has not been to Matanamadh at least once in their lifetime, and your trip to Kutch can only be complete if you have prayed at the Matanamadh. Wonder why Mataji is only half visible? Well, the famous folklore of Ma Ashapura that goes back more than 1,000 years is that a Jain merchant by the name Devchand, who was a devotee of Amba Ma, was on a business trip to Kutch to sell his goods. Being Navratri, he stopped at the village of Madh, where the temple now stands, and did bhakti of Amba Ma, wishing she would bless him with a child. Impressed by his devotion, Ma appeared in his dream and said that he should construct a temple at the very spot so that the travelers like him would have a place to worship. However, Ma also told him that once the temple was constructed, he should close the doors and under no circumstances should he open them before 6 months. Devchand did as instructed and closed the doors and began to guard them. After 5 months, one night he thought he heard the sounds of Janjar, as if a young girl was doing garba inside the temple, and in his excitement forgot what Ma had told him and opened the doors. There she was, as if emerging from Mother Earth, her body knee down still inside the ground. That is how her murti is till date. Devchand, realizing his mistake, was remorseful and apologized repeatedly to Ma. She forgave him and honored his aspirations of having a child with a son.
Ma appeared in the dream of Devchand and fulfilled his dream of having a child. But did you know what happened when she appeared in the dream of Rajput ruler Jam Rawal? Well, Jam Rawal, the ruler of Tera, murdered his uncle Jam Hamir and took over his kingdom of Lakhaviro. He also wanted to kill Khingarji, his 6-month-old child, who was saved by the loyals of his father. Well, Khingarji grew up in Ahmedabad and after winning the praise of Mohammed Begra, used his connection to win back his father's kingdom. So it is believed that Ma Ashapura did not want any of his 2 devotees to be hurt. So she appeared in Jam Rawal's dream and told him to move out of Kutch and she would help him to set up another kingdom. Jam Rawal did just that and found Namnagar, which is the present day Jamnagar. Since then, Ma has fulfilled the wishes of all her devotees and hence the name Ashapura Ma, that is Ashapurna Karni Ma. The temple of Ma has withstood many natural calamities, including the 1819 earthquake and the 2001 earthquake. But the statue of Ma has stood in her glory without even a little bit of a scratch. The Matanamadh is mentioned in the Purans as well as in the Rudramayal Tantra. The Sama Rajputs that came to Kutch and as their wishes for victory were becoming true, the faith in Ma also became stronger. And soon she became the Kuldevi.
Here the facility of food and rooms are also available and here everything is for free. Just before the main temple of Ma Ashapura is this Chanchara Bhavani temple and in this complex is the Chanchara Kund. The importance of this kund is that since 450 years there is a religious tradition that the royal family continues to follow. The Maharao or his representative performs a Chamar Puja at the Momaima temple in Bhuj Darbargarh and carries the Chamars to Matanamadh. On the Saptami day, he takes a bath in this kund and then walks barefoot to the temple of Ashapura Ma where the previous year's Chamars are replaced by the new ones the king has brought. Navratri is the most important festival celebrated with grandeur and enthusiasm for 9 days every single year in honor of Ma Ashapura. Thousands of devotees from all over India visit the temple through Padyatra during auspicious days of Ashwin Navratri. Camps and relief facilities are set up around the road leading to Matanamadh every year for these devotees. So going back to Bhuj from Matanamadh, which is around 90 kilometers, and I hope you enjoyed this video and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!